Welcome back. Last week, actress Antonia Prebble shed her past life, along with the rest of the cast of Outrageous Fortune. It was over and time to move on. So from out west, Antonia has headed south, and as they say, there's something completely different. A stage musical, a lead role in a Christchurch production. Corinne Ambler caught up with the woman formerly known as Loretta West.
House of Suffering and Torment.
She was just 20 years old when our favourite Westies hit the screen 6 years ago. We've watched her grow from prudish schoolgirl.
Well.
Yeah.
It wasn't good for you.
I don't know.
To brothel-owning mother of one. But her newest role since the Wests went west could hardly be more different.
Mama doesn't even have an inkling that I'm working in a nightclub in a pair of lacy pants.
Sally and Loretta are pretty different. And I look, obviously, very different to how Loretta looks. But it's quite a raunchy show, actually. So probably they wouldn't be too surprised at that aspect of it.
Antonia Prebble is playing the lead role of Sally Bowles in the Court Theatre's production of Cabaret. So she's had to do more singing and dancing than she's done in years.
You can tell my brother that ain't grim, because if he squeals on me, I'll squeal on him.
Learning to sing properly so that you don't hurt your voice, because we do a season for 3 months, and I've never done anything remotely like that, so I've been very aware that I need to keep my voice in good condition.
You have to understand the way I am, mine hair.
The play is very different from the movie featuring Liza Minnelli. For a start, the lead in the play is British.
I say, am I shocking you talking this way?
The director, who's never even seen Outrageous Fortune, asked Antonia to audition after seeing her in the chorus line of Sweeney Todd, and says fans will be surprised.
They're going to see a sexy, frilly, frothy, scatterbrain, but who's possibly got some kind of mental disorder, I think.
The cabaret role means Antonia Prebble is away from home for 4 months. She's just bought her first house in Auckland, which is being looked after by flatmates.
I'm loving being down here and living by myself for the first time, which I thought could potentially require a bit of adjusting, but I'm really enjoying it. I walk through the park every day to rehearsal and walk back home, and that's the most lovely way to be able to start and finish every day.
One of the more challenging aspects of her new role is a drink called a prairie oyster, made of a raw egg and Worcester sauce, which her character drinks whenever there's no alcohol.
If I was getting a fake egg or was cracking it behind the table or not actually in the glass, everyone would know. So you just have to go for it. And I have to say, it's not as disgusting as I thought it was going to be.
How many will you have to drink of those by the time the show's over?
12 weeks, 6 shows a week. So 72.
Around 80, yeah.
Yeah. So, and I've already had about, so probably about 80 all up. I've already had a few.
Lucky enough.
Good for my protein, you know. I'm focused on the positives.
The 26-year-old has been packing a lot into her spare time. She's studying part-time for a BA in English Literature. Her last exam was just a week ago.
You said somewhere that you like to get A's. You hard? Do you study a lot?
I do. I'm a bit of a geek. Yeah, I'm a bit of a geek. So.
I saw Robin Malcolm describe you as a geek somewhere as well.
She probably did. I'm quite open about it. I'll wear that badge proudly.
She also has plans for a new exercise regime while south.
I really want to start yoga, that's one thing. All these girls in the show are really flexible and they can do the splits and things, and I just can't touch my toes. So I'm thinking I should probably work on that.
What qualities will Antonia bring to this production?
She's able to be complicated. She's a bit of a chameleon. One minute she'll be a little girl and then she'll be a sexy vamp and then she'll be quite fragile and frightened and then she'll be terribly confident.
Though Prebble has nothing in common with her old character, she says she will still really miss Loretta.
Girls will come up to me and say, oh, my boyfriend really wants to meet you, but he's too scared to because he's scared of you. And I think, I'm really not that scary when you get to know me. But, of course, I can understand it because the only image of me they've got is Loretta, who's terrifying, and I'd probably be quite scared to meet her too.
Though it didn't seem to put this fan off.
I'm Jonathan.
Jonathan, nice to meet you.
Luckily for him, she really is nothing like Loretta.